Hey everyone, Retro John here, and today I am happy to review the new for 21 Masters of the Universe Battle Armor He-Man. All right, so this is one of two first of the deluxe Masters of the Universe Origins figures that we're going to be seeing in this new wave. And I couldn't be more excited that we're finally getting the battle armor. Well, I shouldn't say finally, because I want to admit that this has all really been random as far as their figure lineup goes. Let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging, and we'll take a look at the figure afterwards. So we have a little larger than normal packaging for the figures. We do still have the big red starburst, brick burst coming out. From behind, we got the logo, and this time we have the Battle Armor logo here, which appears to be the same Battle Armor logo that we've gotten with the Vintage line, which is awesome. We have some artwork this time on the single carded packaging in the front. It does say it is part of the deluxe figure set. Most powerful armor in the universe. Strike armor to reveal battle damage. So yes, this is going to have that battle spin feature. And you'll notice some extra goodies packaged in, which we'll of course go over. We got the Vintage He-Man head, which is awesome. We hadn't seen this since the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive, which I did not do a review for. I still haven't opened that figure, and I'm still kind of debating whether or not I'm going to, honestly. So we'll go over all of these, and you'll see that it even comes with a mini comic. So let's go ahead and go over the back. We have some wonderful artwork here with Battle Armor He-Man and Man-at-Arms going after Merman. He-Man storms in the battle protected by the mighty battle armor that was crafted by Man-at-Arms. So that's pretty cool, and you can see Merman's doing damage to that armor. And here it shows exactly how the battle armor works, which is really, really cool. And we get a cross-sell of all the new figures in this wave. Here's Battle Armor He-Man. We have She-Ra, Roboto. We have Battle Armor Skeletor, which we're going to be doing a review of him later. So awesome. Merman, which I still need to find Roboto, Merman, Zodak, and look. Check this out. We got a deluxe Clamp Champ coming as well. Battle Cat, Panthor. So very, very cool. I mean, this line is just growing, and I'm so excited for it. So let's go ahead and open up Battle Armor He-Man and take a look at him out of the packaging. All right, so here we have our Battle Armor He-Man out of the package, and he looks awesome. Now, you're just going to notice something slightly off on this, and it's probably going to go true with Skeletor when I review him, is you'll notice that the battle damage spring indicator, the battle damage indicator looks a lot smaller than the Vintage. It's not just your eyes, it is mine as well, and I believe that is true. So, without big elephant in the room, get it out of the way. Let's go ahead and go over articulation, and we'll talk more about this. So, his head is a different sculpt than the Vintage, well, not the Vintage, than the first, the original release He-Man. We'll go over a comparison here. The head is on that ball joint, so it can spin all the way around, left, right, look up, down. The arms do go out. They do go forward and backwards. They do bend at the elbow. They have the twist at the elbow. Both have the hinge here to bend the wrist as well as swivel. You can move his legs out that far. He can move them forwards, backwards. He can twist at the waist. He can bend at the knee. He can boot cut swivel as well as the hinged boots there. So pretty cool. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at more at his new head sculpt. He looks pretty angry. Looks like he's battle ready. And yeah, pretty darn cool. If you don't like this head sculpt, you can sculpt it. I mean, you can trade it with the other He-Man head from the line, or one of his accessory heads, which I'll bring out in just a moment. His armor, it looks cool. Now, I want to say this looks a lot more lightweight than the vintage, I think, also. But it's not really a bad thing. I don't feel like I'm going to really break him. So you're going to notice here on the back something a little different. The other battle armor He-Man, the vintage, didn't have this. His holster for either his sword or his axe, which he comes with. I'm digging pretty much the same kind of sculpts and paint jobs and everything, except when we get down to the boots. The boots, you'll notice, are actually the straps here are painted. The same boots, I believe they're the same color, except the straps here this time are painted. So you can take these and pull them off if you want, I believe. Supposed to be able to. Give me a moment. I can do this. I'll sweat. I'm not going to do it. It's being a pain in the butt. But we all know that the limbs are removable. In fact, check that out. The waist is still removable. Snaps right back on. All right, let's go ahead and do the action feature. I know you're waiting for it. So, here's that He-Man H. If you just tap it once, battle damage once. Tap it again, battle damage thrice. Pretty cool. And the fact that you could still remove the waist and change it is pretty cool. So you could essentially give this armor to another hero if you want. I find it a little bit more difficult because of how small it is. I have grown-up thumbs now, because you used to be able to just, no problem. This tends to be a little bit more difficult, I think, to turn back. Oh, there we go. Now let's go over his accessories, because he actually comes with quite a few. I already mentioned his sword and shield, so let's bring that in. He has his sword, which is really, really cool. It can fit in his hand, like so. And yes, there have been fans complaining. It is half of a sword. Did I call it a shield? I did call it a shield. Oh yeah, yeah, it is a sword. Now, he comes with his battle axe, which, oh my, he can't hold it. Unless I take his sword out of his hand, so I can store it in his back, if I so choose to do so. Or I could take his sword, put it in the back, and put his axe in his hand, if I so choose to do so. Or, how about I just take his wrist off and replace it with his other hand that he came with? Yes, this He-Man comes with another hand. So he can take his sword in one hand and axe in the other. Actually, we're gonna switch these around. Just cause preference. My preference. There we go. Now he can dual wield and look incredibly awesome. And if that ain't cool enough, check this out. So, we have this little energy thing here. Come on, He-Man, look. Look at your camera. Yeah. So that's kind of neat, I guess. What is it for? Well, you just put it at the, on the, sword, and there you go. You can, yeah. It's quite heavy, though. In fact, it even came with instructions. And believe it or not, I believe there's two different types here at the end. One for the individual sword, and it actually tells you for the first time ever instructions that you can combine He-Man and Skeletor's sword, sold separately, And you can put that in there. That's kind of neat. And this was folded up like that inside his other accessory, a brand new mini comic. Yes, this is not the mini comic that came with She-Ra. This is a whole new mini comic that came with the Battle Armor He-Man. It'll come with the Battle Armor Skeletor too. It explains the origins of the armor, I believe. Haven't read it yet, but I did look through it. So if you want to know, boom, we have some King Randor. We got some Clamp Champ. We got some Palace Guards. We got King Randor and Malina, Queen Malina. Look at this. We have the Skeletor robots here, which is incredibly awesome. And we also get Ram Man, who has been confirmed to be a deluxe figure coming soon. And this is just awesome. Love this Battle Cat. That is so cool. Yeah, absolutely love this. And of course, we have our cross cell art on the back. So very, very cool. Now for the final accessory. Are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? The vintage style He-Man head. Yes! Yes! So, I'm taking this off because it's really being overweight. Alright. So how you do this is you just pop this head off, like so, and pop the new head on, like, is it on? I'm not sure if it's on. Like so. That doesn't look right. I want to try it again. There we go. I think I had a pie. There we go. And look at that. We have vintage style He-Man's head. How cool is this? But you know what? I did something. Yes, I did. I did something. Let me switch back my heads here. Hang out here for a moment, He-Man. Battle Armor He-Man. I took out my other Origins He-Man. And you know what I did? I took his head off. Like that. And I took the vintage head and I placed it on the palm, the ball joint, like so. And I push down and check this out. We now have a vintage style Masters of the Universe He-Man figure. And if we just do a little bit of this here, I set him down, whoop, and knock over Battle Armor He-Man. Now we get a very vintage looking He-Man. That is just awesome. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm contemplating leaving this head on. I really, really am. And you can see that the sculpt and everything, the color matches this body. So it's very tempting to leave this head on. Not gonna lie. But we're not here to talk about this He-Man. We are not. There we go. So it's a very cool head sculpt. I absolutely love that we have this. That might be my fault for trying to plug it in just now. So yeah, overall, I really like this figure. So these are showing up at Targets right now. I've been going every day looking for new Origin figures. I got lucky to find She-Ra, found Panther. I got just today I found him and Skeletor on the peg. So I'll be doing a Skeletor video as well. This is just absolutely insane that we're getting these in 2021. I'm loving this. This is right now my favorite toy line. It really, really is. And honestly, it's always been my favorite toy line. I cannot lie. So, hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel. If you haven't already, please. That like button lets me know you care. And leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of this brand new Battle Armor He-Man figure. I really like it. But sometimes I like Skeletor a little better. We'll see. Until next time, on Eternia, like in Eternia, we do not say goodbye. We say good journey.